liar. Home Office declares bold action to shut down Harry's biggest lie, he did not offer to pay. Prince Harry's appeal to fund his own security when he returns to the UK has been contradicted by a recent Home Office statement, a royal correspondent has claimed. The Duke of Sussex legal team state that he wants to return to the UK to see family and friends and that most of all, this is and always will be his home. The Home Office is currently locked in a High Court battle over his bid to personally fund his own security when he arrives in the UK. The Duke of Sussex is currently making a legal challenge against a February 2020 decision by the Royal and VIP Executive Committee, Ravec, which prevents him from paying for his own security whilst in the UK. But there is now a discrepancy between Prince Harry and the Home Office over his original claim that he wanted to fund his own security. Matt Wilkinson, royal correspondent at The Sun, tweeted, "Last month after the Mail on Sunday broke the story, a spokesman for Harry responded with, 'The Duke first offered to pay personally for UK police protection for himself and his family in January of 2020 at Sandringham. That offer was dismissed.' However, Mr. Wilkinson then said the Home Office had strong words in response to Harry's claims he would fund private security. In documents handed to the court, the Home Office states Harry did not offer private funding when he returned in June 2021 or any of the pre-action correspondence which followed. Home Office lawyers then explained to court on Friday that it was irrelevant for the Duke of Sussex to ask to pay for his own security in the UK. Robert Palmer QC, acting for the Home Office, said, "Personal protective security by the police is not available on a privately financed basis. Ravec does not make decisions on the provision of such security on the basis that any financial contribution could be sought or obtained to pay for it." The Home Office also claimed that Prince Harry's offer to fund his own security on return to the UK was notably not advanced to Ravec at the time of his visit in June 2021. The Home Office added that his was not communicated in any pre-action discussions. Prince Harry has also raised questions over his return to the UK for Jubilee celebrations, with it being particularly unlikely his wife, Meghan Markle, and two children, Archie and Lilibet, will visit. Richard Fitzwilliams told Express.co.uk, "Questions will continue to be asked about the role Harry might play in the Jubilee celebrations in June." He noted particular fears over questions of security, noting the implications this could have on the attendance of Harry's family. Mr. Fitzwilliams said, "The Duke's fears over security make it unlikely that Meghan, Archie and Lilibet will attend." Prince Harry's legal representatives added that he does not feel safe visiting with the current security arrangements in place. During a hearing at London's Royal Courts of Justice, the Duke argued that his US private protection team does not have adequate jurisdiction abroad or access to UK intelligence information. He claims that he needs further assistance to keep his family safe when they are in the UK. Prince Harry has said he wanted to fund his own security on return to the UK, rather than impose on the British taxpayer. Mr. Fitzwilliams added that Prince Harry will deal a further blow to the royal family later this year when he publishes his memoir. One friend of the Duke of Sussex suggested the Duchess of Cornwall could come under particular scrutiny in the highly anticipated book. On Camilla, Mr. Fitzwilliams also said it was noticed that neither nor his wife commented publicly on the dramatic announcement that she would become Queen Consort rather than Princess Consort when Prince Charles is crowned King. This despite him having spent the week in which the news was announced talking movingly about other matters. The royal expert said, "We must hope that they sent best wishes privately." Prince Harry's friend, meanwhile, told the Mirror the memoir is bound to shake the monarchy to the core.